Praise the Lord, church. Praise the Lord. What do you say about Jesus? What do you say about Jesus? He's good all the time. And all the time he's good. Amen? We bring you greetings in the mighty name of Jesus this morning. Truly, I do not style myself as a visitor, for this seems it's like a home away from home. So I am so thankful and honored to be before you today, just to once again to see your faces, to be in fellowship with you, to glorify and magnify the Lord. We thank you for your heartfelt welcome. We thank you for your smiles. We thank you for your love. But most of all, we thank you for the presence of the Holy Spirit that rules and rests in this place, that truly is the common denominator that allows us to come together in love and unity to give the Lord praise. Amen. And it is an honor today, as the man of God has spoken, to be able to have my husband to travel to Kenya with me this time. It's been a time now almost since 2004 that I had my first opportunity to come to Kenya and to share. And through the years, it had been my heart's felt desire that my husband one day would come here to Kenya and to see the work that God is doing across the waters and across the globe. And as God was preparing this time to come, I've been speaking with my husband, and I was sharing with him the goodness of God and everything that he's doing. And within not long, the Lord laid upon his heart that it was time for him to come. How many of us know that God's timing is the best time? How many of us know when we get out of the way and let God be in the way that things happen? And today I'm here rejoicing in the God of my salvation, because the Lord has graced one of my prayers and one of my desires for the man of God, my husband, none other than Jeffrey Allen Davis Sr., that has been my love for the past 30 years. And it is an honor and a privilege to present to you, each of you here today, this powerful, wonderful, gracious, loving man of God that has a word for you today that will, I hope, bless your heart and renew your spirit and encourage you to know that Jesus is Lord in all things. Thank you once again for your gracious honor. Hallelujah.
Now give Jesus a hand clap of praise. Oh, we can do better than that. He can't hear you. Come on, come on, come. That's what I like. Make some noise for the Lord. Praise God. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. We thank God. We honor the presence of the Lord. Thank you.
Let them get free.
Thank you. Praise God. We just greet you in the name of Jesus, and we honor the presence of the Lord in this place, and your bishop, Bishop Kamani, who has visited our place some years ago. I haven't seen him in, oh my God, it's been over 10, 12 years when he visited us. But we thank God for him and all of you, and we honor Pastor Jeffrey. Praise God. And our beautiful wife, Pastor D, and she's talked about you all. I've seen you on film. I've seen you on camera. And I just want to, you know, wholeheartedly thank you for how you have welcomed her and how you have taken care of her when she's been here. You know, it's one thing when your wife has gone miles over the ocean. Praise God. You really got to trust God. Can somebody say amen? Amen? I'm just being transparent. You really have to trust God. And we did just that. But I thank you for welcoming her and loving her and taking care of her. Praise God. We appreciate that. And I, being a pastor, I don't take that lightly. So there's something, praise God, and I believe that the Lord's going to do that, to reciprocate how you have blessed her for the Lord. Praise God, to use us as an instrument to bless you today. Is that okay? Praise God. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we just thank you, O God, for this opportunity just to present your word, O God. And Father, I come as a humble servant, O God. And Father, you speak through me, O God. And Father, I yield my members unto you. Father, be thou glorified, O God, and prepare the hearts of your people, O God, to receive what thus saith the Lord. We believe you for signs, wonders, and miracles this day. Be thou, be thou glorified. So careful to give you all the glory, honor, and praise. In Christ's name we pray, amen. Praise God. We'll be talking a little bit as we were talking to Bishop last night and Pastor Jeffrey, and we were just trying to get just the understanding of the flow that you all have been flowing there, that the Lord has been doing. And they talked about the worship, praise God, the worship of the Lord. And truly, we have experienced that worship experience today, praise God. And I ask a question. How many true worshipers are in the house? Raise your hand. True worshipers. True worshipers. Worship is very important. And we're going to talk a little bit about true worshipers today. But open your Bibles to St. John. St. John, 4th chapter. St. John, chapter 4. And we'll use this for our base scripture as we talk about worship today. And I'm sure you know this passage of scripture very well, very familiar passage of scripture. And Jesus and the woman at the well. St. John chapter 4, King James Version, 4:1. When therefore the Lord knew how the Pharisees had heard that Jesus made and baptized more disciples than John, though Jesus himself baptized not, but his disciples, he left Judea and departed again into Galilee. And he must needs go through Samaria. Then cometh he to a city of Samaria, which is called Sychar, near the parcel ground of that Jacob gave to his son Joseph. Now Jacob's well was there. Somebody say, Jacob's well. Jesus, therefore, being wearied with his journey, sat thus on the well. And it was about the sixth hour. There cometh a woman of Samaria to draw water. Jesus saith unto her, give me to drink. For his disciples were gone away unto the city to buy meat. Then saith the woman of Samaria unto him, how is it that thou, being a Jew, askest drink of me, which am a woman of Samaria? My God. For the Jews have no dealings with Samaritans. Jesus answered and said unto her, if thou knewest the gift of God, and who it is that saith to thee, give me drink, thou wouldest have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water. Somebody say, living water. The woman saith unto him, sir, thou hast nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. From whence then hast thou that living water? Art thou greater than our father Jacob, which gave us this well, and drank thereof himself, and his children, and his cattle? Jesus answered and said unto her, whosoever drinketh of this water shall never shall thirst again, but whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst, but the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life. Say amen. So as we talk about these wells, we want to just capture some history about the wells, if you will, because as we talk about these wells, the wells are really, when we look in the Bible, keys to releasing worship. And I'm going to just talk about four keys. Hopefully we'll get through them. Keys to releasing worship through the wells in the Bible. So, as we see here, you know the story very well, and Jesus met the woman at the well, and they had a conversation, but Jesus had an opportunity to witness to her. Praise God. And he said, whosoever drinketh the water I shall give him shall never thirst, but the water I shall give him, a well of water springing up into everlasting life. How many have a desire to have everlasting life? That's what we're over here for, to obtain everlasting life. But if we look at the history of the wells in the scripture, the things that we want to focus on in these wells, I'm going to give you a few nuggets about the wells. First, be the foundation covenant wells, as we see in the Bible, in the book of Genesis, how Genesis 12, and Jesus spoke to Abraham, and he made a covenant with Abraham. And he told him, he said, get thee out of thy country. Amen. And he said, get out. In other words, I'm going to make a covenant with you. And he said, I'm going to make you a great nation, and I will bless thee. I'm going to make your name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. I will bless them that bless thee. I will curse them that curse thee. And all the families of the earth shall be blessed. Praise God. And it says, Abraham departed as the Lord had spoken with him, and Lot with him. And Abram was 75 years old when he departed out of Haran. So here we see this covenant wells, how Abram responded to the call of God by faith in God. Hallelujah. He said, you know, he went out and he didn't know where he was going, but he knew that he was in the arms of the Lord. How many know it's a good thing to be in the arms of the Lord? And as we talk about this worship today, you know, we want to understand that worship means, if you will, worship or worthiness or dignity, as we look at worship, a paying of homage or respect to, as we look at worship. We can look at worship mean reverent devotion unto, as we are devoted unto the Lord. We're devoted unto the service of God, praise God. And we understand that worship, as we were doing earlier, is going to include, praise God, it's going to include praise, it's going to include prayer, it's going to include preaching. These are all forms of worship unto the Lord. And worship also, it will embrace the temple, it will embrace music, it will embrace it denotes a bowing, if you will, a simulation of bowing and reverence and honor devoted to, as we talk about worship. It will, when we bow, it will signify an inward attitude as we bow unto the Lord. Amen. You know, our attitude must be a sign of humility to get to a place of worship to the Lord. So, in other words, what I'm saying, it is a process to enter into a place of worship. But we as people of God have to understand, as we recognize the first, as he told Abraham, we have to be in covenant. Number one, so we have to be in covenant with the Lord. And we want to understand that covenant is important. Covenant is an agreement. We're in agreement with God. God sets forth the parameters of the covenant, but we must adhere to the covenant that God has set forth. In other words, it's unilateral. God sets forth the parameters of the covenant. So number one is covenant. So the covenant wells. Praise God. And so as we look more into the scripture, Genesis 26, if we go there, and mind you, we're talking about the ways or some keys to get to release the worship. Understanding covenant. We as people of God need to understand Genesis 26. Isaac, as we look at the wells of inheritance. The Bible says we are of the inheritance of them which are what? Sanctified. So here we use for the example, in the Bible, Genesis 26, beginning at the 15th verse. And it's talking about these wells. It says, For all the wells which his father's servants had digged in the days of Abraham, his father, the Philistines had what? Stopped them and filled them with earth. And Abimelech said to Isaac, go from us, for thou art much mightier than we. And Isaac departed thence and pitched his tent in the valley of Gerar and dwelt there. And Isaac digged wells, again the wells of water, which they had digged in the days of Abraham, his father. For the Philistines had stopped them after the death of Abraham and called their names after the names by which his father had called them. And Isaac's servant digged in the valley and found there a well of springing water. Hallelujah. And the herdmen of Gerar did strive with Isaac's herdmen, saying, the water is ours. And he called the name of the well Esek, because they strove with him. And they digged another well and strove for that also, and called the name Sitna, and removed from this and digged another well. And for that they strove not, and he called the name of this Rehoboth, and said, for now the Lord had made room for us, for we shall be fruitful in the land. So here we see at Isaac's well, it was the wells of inheritance. But Isaac had to redig the wells, praise God, that was stopped up by the Philistines. And we want to understand on this journey, praise God, as we get to worship, sometimes we have to redig the wells and uncover the wells to get to the presence of God. Sometimes there are distractions there to try to distract us from getting to that place with God. But understanding we are in covenant with God and we have an inheritance through the wells. We see that. They dig the well. They dug the wells again and again, and they strived. They had to fight for the wells. But there came a time when they said, hey, the Lord has made room for us, and we shall be fruitful in the land. If you study out the scripture, how Isaac, he was plenteous and good because the land was promised unto him. How many want everything that God has promised unto you? The promise of God are true and assured, and amen. But they digged, and they were consistent in their digging because they knew the promises that had been given unto Abram through the covenant. He said, in you, my family is going to be blessed. Your seed will be blessed. The earth shall be blessed. And now Isaac, praise God, after Abram died, Philistine, praise God, they begin to cover the well. To cover the wells. Understanding praise. Hallelujah. Being a part of worship. Has anybody ever been into a place where it seems like the praise is just wrapped up? Or their praise can't be released. Praise God unto God. But glory be to God. Oh, if men would just praise the Lord. Oh, if men would just exalt the name of the Lord. I believe we will get to that aspect of worship. So okay, so let's move on. So we see Isaac's wells of inheritance, and now let's get to Jacob's well of blessing. Genesis the 48th chapter. As we go to Genesis 48, Genesis 48, we begin reading. Here we see the story of Joseph, the next generation. 15, and he blessed Joseph and said, God before whom my father Abraham and Isaac did walk, the God which fed me all my life long until this day, the angel which redeemed me from evil, bless the lads and let my name be named on them. In the name of my fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and let them grow into a multitude in the midst of the earth. And when Joseph saw that his father laid his right hand upon the head of Ephraim, it displeased him. And he held up his father's hand to remove it from Ephraim's head to Manasseh's head. And Joseph said unto his father, not so, my father, for this is the firstborn. Put thy right hand upon his head. And the father refused and said, I know it, my son, I know it. And he shall also become a people, and he shall also be great. But truly his brother shall be greater than he, and his seed shall become a multitude of nations. So here we see that Jacob blessed Ephraim over Manasseh. And we know that traditionally the oldest son was the ones that received the blessing. But here we see, as an example, Jacob's well of blessing. So that's where the story picks up, where Jesus meets the woman at the well. It was at Jacob's well of blessing. And we see that Jesus had an encounter. So the well is significant as we look at, praise God, us getting to a place of worship, then understanding covenant, understanding our inheritance, and understanding our blessing. Every good and perfect gift comes from above, from the blessing of the Lord. So as we see in the Bible, in this message, how Jesus met the woman at the well. And he had an encounter with her. And Jesus went through this land, this ground, and it says he went to the parcel ground that Jacob gave his son Joseph. And his well was there, and he met the lady, and she said, give me to drink. And understanding that the Jews and the Samaritans, praise God, they did not have any relationship with each other. They despised each other. So the woman thought it was uncommon for a Jewish man, praise God, to inquire a question from her. But we want to understand Jesus took the opportunity to witness to her, to tell her about some living water. But that living water was down in Jacob's well. So what are you saying, preacher? The opportunity to get to that place of worship comes through the well of the water of Christ. Because Christ is the only one that can make you free and set you free. Because he that the Son set free is what? Free indeed. Is anybody in here free today? But the Bible indicates in the book of Galatians, as we, praise God, receive the anointing of God, because it has been, as we look at Galatians 3, there's been a command upon the Gentiles for the power of God to move. We have an inheritance. Galatians 3. And one. And Paul writes to him, O ye foolish Galatians, who have bewitched you that ye should not obey the truth, before whose eyes Jesus Christ had been evidently set forth and crucified among you? Are ye so foolish, having begun in the spirit, now made perfect by the flesh? Thank you. Have you suffered many things in vain, yet be in vain? He therefore that ministered to you the Spirit and worketh miracles among you, doth he by the works of the law or by the hearing of faith? Even as Abraham believed God, it was accounted unto him for what? Righteousness. Now you know therefore they which are of the faith, the same children of Abraham. And the scripture foreseeing that God would justify the heathen through faith, preached before the gospel unto Abraham, saying, in thee all nations shall be blessed. So they which be of the faith are blessed with who? Faithful Abraham. For as many as are the works of the law are under the curse, for it is written, cursed is everyone that continueth not in all things which are written in the book of the law to do what? To do them. But that no man is justified by the law in the sight of God. It is evident that what? The just shall live by faith. And the law is not of faith, but the man that doeth them shall live in them. Christ hath what? Redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, for it is written, cursed is everyone that hangeth on the tree, that the blessing of Abraham might come on the Gentiles through Jesus Christ, that we might receive the promise of the Spirit, how? Through faith. So the blessings of Abraham might come on the Gentiles, that we might receive what? The promise of the Spirit. How do we receive it? Through faith. All right, so now we see Jesus speaking to the woman, praise God, the Samaritan woman, but the application to us is that we might receive the promise of the Spirit, how? Through faith. Brethren, I speak after the manner of men, though, but it be man's covenant, yet it be confirmed, not man be disallowed or added unto. So here we see at the well, the application to us being of that Gentile nation, we have the ability, praise God, to be adopted into the family, not being Jews, but God, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. And being made free from the curse, praise God, hallelujah, we have been given the ability to receive the Spirit of the Lord. Amen. Does anybody in here have the Spirit of the Lord? And it's one thing about the Spirit of the Lord, praise God. The Spirit of the Lord will give you a place of understanding that you can come to the wells, praise God, in a place of thanksgiving. Amen. That you can come to the wells with a place of praise, and you can get to the wells with a place of worship, because we want to get the true worshipers. Any true worshipers in the house? He said, the true worshipers shall worship him and what? In spirit and in truth. So we understand that thanksgiving is a part of worship. Amen. Praise is a part of worship. Amen. Hallelujah. Preaching is a part of worship. Obedience is a part of worship. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Humility is a part of worship. Hallelujah. Faith is a part of worship. But we need to identify who we are in Christ. I believe sometimes today there's been an identity crisis of who we are in Christ. Once we recognize who we are the inheritance of them that are sanctified. Once we realize, praise God, that he has made us the head and not the tail. Once we realize that we are above only and shall not be beneath, praise God, we will walk in the covenant that Christ has made with us. And he that the Son set free is what? Free indeed. So we're on our way to worship. But once we enter into that covenant with God, we understand that obedience will take us from faith, to glory to glory. Praise God. How many like to obey God? How many love the word of God? This is important that we obey the word of God and understand that we have an inheritance. I want everything that God has for me. What about you? What God has for you is for you, praise God. And what God has for me is for me. But we have an inheritance, praise God. We are an inheritance of them that are sanctified. We are an inheritance of the Spirit of God. We are an inheritance. We have been adopted into the body through the power of the Holy Ghost. Amen. So it's a wells of blessing. The Lord has pour out blessing upon the people of God. But as we get back to this main scripture, I got a few minutes. I'm going to get back to this main scripture in John and get to the point that we want to get to about getting to a place of worship. We know they had no dealings with one another, but Jesus, praise God, began to challenge the woman, praise God, and she answered. And she recognized, praise God, that this must be the Christ. Once we come into a place of recognition of who Christ is, we can identify who we are, praise God. So the question is that, who do you say that Jesus is? And once we identify who Jesus is, we can identify what he has placed in us. We can identify that we are true worshipers. We can have an understanding, praise God, that the true worshipers must worship him in spirit and in truth. But true worshipers, there's one thing about true worshipers, we worship God alone. Nobody but God. Praise God. He said, I'll have no other God before me. True worship, nobody but God. Hallelujah. Nobody can do you like Jesus. Praise God. God alone is to be worshiped. God the Father and God the Son alone is to be worshiped. The Bible indicates that angels worship God. Praise God. Worship other gods. We know that it is forbidden to worship, put anything before God. Hallelujah. And true worship, one thing about true worship is not mechanical. It's not choreographed. True worship must be spontaneous and inspired by the Spirit of God as we see true worship. Hallelujah. And, you know, true worship is not just this vain repetition of rituals, if you will, but true worship must be wholehearted and it must be reverent unto the Lord. Hallelujah. How many know the Lord is not accepting every kind of worship? Praise God. But we want to know it should be based upon our obedience in our lifestyle that has in itself, our obedience represents our worship unto the Lord. Remember, worship, we said, indicates worship. Huh? Worship. So if we are obedient unto the Lord, we are acknowledging, praise God, that He is supreme God. He is the Almighty God. He is the eternal creator. And worship should be in accordance with God's command. Amen. God commands it. Worship should not be mechanical. Worship should give honor due unto Him. Praise God. How many give honor unto the Lord? How many love to get honor unto the Lord? It's due unto Him. The Bible indicates, praise God, we should worship Him. How? In the beauty of holiness. Praise God. Worship should be orderly. My God, the Bible talks about orderly worship, praise God, and the priests, how they assemble when they carried the ark. There was order about the worship of God. But when you are led by the Spirit, you will connect, praise God, and identify where God is trying to take you to. Even though, praise God, hallelujah, it may seem like that the enemy is trying to cover up, praise God, your wellspring of water, not to allow the wellspring of worship to flow through you. The enemy comes in like a flood and try to hold back your praise, which is a part of your worship, praise God. It seems like the first thing that may go is your praise. Has anybody ever been challenged? Seem like the first thing go with their praise? Don't feel like praising you. Don't have a desire to praise you. But the Bible said, let everything that have breath praise ye the Lord. Praise Him, hallelujah, for His excellent greatness. Praise Him for His mighty acts. Praise Him just because He is God, not necessarily because He's done anything for you, but just praise Him just because He's God. Can somebody say hallelujah? Can somebody say hallelujah? Can somebody say thank you, Jesus? Because when we look back over our life, when we tried to get to this place of worship, it seemed like the enemy, the Philistine, praise God, the enemy come in like a flood and try to cover the well. But the land is already promised unto us. Eternal life is already promised unto us. And can't no devil in hell hold back God's blessings for you, for me. Can't no devil in hell hold back the promises of God. Can't no devil hold back the power of God, which is invested in you through the power of the Holy Ghost. And now is the time, praise God, because it's a war going on. How many know it's a war going on? Praise God. And the war is not natural. It's supernatural, praise God. It's in the heavenlies. And so we have to war and wage war in the heavenlies. But one thing about it, we got to start waging war using our weapons, because the Bible says the weapons of our warfare, they're not carnal, but they're mighty through God, through the pulling down of strongholds. So once we enter in covenant with God, we got to begin to praise God so we can pull down strongholds. See, stronghold trying to put dirt in your well, praise God. But the well is like Jacob's well, and Jacob's well down deep. The lady said that down deep in the well, the water was flowing. And it's down deep in your spirit that water is flowing. So we got to uncover the wells, praise God, and we got to be diligent, praise God, in our praise. Because David said, praise God, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. I don't know about you, but I came miles cross over the ocean, and I'm glad to be in the house of the Lord. I'm glad to be amongst them that are sanctified, praise God. God got holy folk everywhere, praise God. And I'm glad to be in that number. I'm glad we can praise God in the beauty of holiness. I'm glad we can rejoice in the God of our salvation. I'm glad, praise God, that I got people of God, hallelujah, that can agree with the Spirit of God to wage some war. It's time to pull down stronghold. The devil is a lie. He can't hold back my prey, just as the Philistine will lie. They can't kick no dirt and branches all in my well, because I'm at Jacob's well, and it's deep, praise God, and there's water flowing down, praise God. That's what Jesus was talking about. My God, he wasn't so much talking about the natural water, but he's talking about the supernatural water. And I believe, praise God, that that supernatural water will allow you to be an overcomer. Any overcomers in here? Praise God. Any overcomers in here? Any warriors in here? Praise God. Anybody like to fight? Well, you may as well fight. If you're a soldier in the army of the Lord, you've been inducted to fight the good fight of faith. But one thing about it is, to God before you, who can be against you? If God before you, who can be against you? I don't care what comes, what goes. Praise God, I'm a child of the Most High God. He has made us kings and priests. Is it all right to walk in the priesthood? Praise God, we are royalty. We are a holy nation, a royal priesthood. Therefore, the Bible said we should show forth praises unto God. Praise God. What did you bring to the king? You can't come to the king and don't bring nothing. You got to bring something to the king. You can't enter into the presence of the king unless he stretched out his scepter. Praise God. And he said, beckon you to come. Well, did you bring your praise today if you're trying to get to a place of worship? Did you bring your obedience today trying to get to a place of worship? When you get to the place of worship, you enter the place behind the veil. Praise God. That's where we're trying to get to, the holiest of holy. Praise God. When you get in the presence of the Lord, the Bible says in the presence of the Lord is the fullness of joy. And we have the opportunity to walk in that fullness of joy when every day, every minute. My God, don't you know, over 2,000 years ago, when Jesus went down in the grave, he got up out of that grave. Couldn't no grave hold his body down. Praise God. And the veil was torn from top to bottom. Therefore, signifying the way into the Holy of Holy was made available through worship. My God, but you need to understand, through worship, first you got to praise God. Why don't you enter into his gate? See, the priest had to take a course of action to get behind the veil. But the Bible said, enter into his gates with thanksgiving. I don't know about you, but I remember when I was younger, the days of old, the mothers, hallelujah, praise God, the fathers, praise God, they used to enter into the church. Hey, how are you? Praising God, praise God. Something was stirring down on the inside of the saints of God. But now, praise God, it seems like, praise God, we need the music to pump up the praise. Seem like we need the singing to pump up a praise. If we just think of the goodness of Jesus just because of who he is, praise start to pump up down in me. Worship, my God, begins to activate in me, because the love that Jesus has for me and the love that I got for Jesus. But God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. This same spirit, praise God, is the spirit that Jesus was telling the woman at the well. Praise God, you need the taste of the living water. People, we need to stir up the gift of God that is down in us. Praise God. God is life. Hallelujah. Praise God. God is spirit. Don't you know? Praise God, that we just stir up the gift of God. How many got the spirit of God? We need to activate our spirit. We need to stir up our spirit. My God, we need a download. We need to be recharged, hallelujah, by the Spirit of God, hallelujah. That's why we come to the house of God, so we can be in agreement, so the Lord God can bless you. How many love the blessings of the Lord? But one thing we say, no deposit, no return. You got to bring something and put something in. Because the Bible said the Lord is seeking, my God. Hallelujah. He's seeking for true worshipers. He's seeking for those that will worship him in spirit and in truth. That means you got to deny yourself and crucify your flesh. If you're going to get to a place of worship in the Lord, it's time for the body of Christ to begin to crucify. Somebody say crucify. We got to crucify this flesh, praise God, and we got to take dominion. Praise God, somebody say dominate. In other words, in this war, God given us the ability to dominate. Say dominate. My God, because after that, the Holy Ghost come upon you. After you tasted this, my God, this living water, you'll never thirst again. In the natural, you're going to thirst. But in the supernatural, once you get endued with power, once you get enabled by the power of the Holy Ghost, you'll never thirst again. Because the power of the Lord will endue you, praise God. The power of the Lord will free you. The power of the Lord will sanctify you. The power of the Lord will justify you. You've been made right with God through the power of the Spirit. You've been redeemed from the curse of the law. Praise God, you've been free from the curse. Be not entangled again. My God, don't be tied up. We've been free. Hallelujah. Be not entangled again, praise God. Hallelujah, when you're on your place to worship. Praise God, the enemy sometime will come to your mind, praise God. Anybody having an encounter, praise God, when the enemy will torment you, he will come, my God, but he'll come out against you one way, but you got to flee seven ways because of the power of God. Boom, you can't touch it. The Lord is a shield. He's a fence all about you. Nobody can penetrate. No devil can penetrate, praise God, the power of God. I'm trying to get the people of God to see what God has invested in you. He has made an investment in you. Praise God. No, you know, every time we make an investment, we look for what? A return on our investment. My God, all is God is looking for us to get to a place of worship with him, a place of humility with him. Praise God, a place of obedience with him. That's all God's looking for. A place of worship. Somebody say worship. Somebody say worship. See, when you begin to worship, you begin to break every chain. When you begin to worship, you begin to destroy yokes. Hallelujah. When you begin to worship, you begin to pull down strongholds. See, my God, hallelujah. My God, the Lord is true. The Lord is real. But one thing about worship, praise God, when you get to a place, hallelujah, just you and the Lord. Just you and Jesus. In that secret place, when you get to that throne room, my God, experience. How many have ever had that throne room experience? The throne room. Just the presence of God. See, in the old, that's what when the priest went behind the veil, the glory and the power of God would meet him in the holies of holies. That's where we're trying to get to. Because when you get to that place of worship, we'll honor God. We'll bow down. We'll reverence. We'll lay prostrate. Not only naturally, but supernaturally in our spirit. A place of adoration. A place of acceptance. A place of love. A place that an exchange is being made. An exchange. As we pour out, he pours in. As we pour out, he pours in. As we pour out, he fills our cup. And he runneth over with love, with joy, with peace, with long suffering, with gentleness, with meekness, with faith. The fruit of the Spirit he's pouring into his people. A place of worship. But we got to have confidence in approaching God. Hallelujah. We need to, Hebrews talk about drawing near with a true heart and full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled from evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. It's something about the washing of the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Something about the blood of Jesus that can wash you from the inside out, that can clean up a sinner man like me. something about the blood of Jesus that can give you a new insight on where you need to go, how you need to get there, and what you need to do when you get there. In other words, he's a God of providence. He's a sovereign God. He's all powerful. All power belongs to him. But worshipers have to have a proper and true attitude. In other words, the Bible in Leviticus, it talks about a time of preparation. Preparation. How do we prepare to get to that place of worship? Examine. Are we preparing ourselves to get to that place of worship? Are we coming wholeheartedness before the Lord? And the Bible indicates we ought to love the Lord with all of our heart, all of our soul, all of our might, everything we have, we should love Jesus. Everything. That's true worship. That's true denying of ourselves. And we should have confidence as we draw near to God. Understanding the wells of thanksgiving, praise, and worship. Here's the key. The kingdom, worship, and the stream of the Holy Ghost. Through the kingdom, we have power. Somebody say power. Through the worship, praise God, we have transformation. Through the stream of the Holy Spirit, we have the presence of God. Three keys: kingdom, worship, and stream of the Holy Spirit. But the well of thanksgiving, the well of praise, and the well of worship all flow from the throne of the Lord. And as we see, hallelujah, Jesus, as he interpreted her, he told her, you don't even know what you worship, my God. 22, ye know not what. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. But the hour cometh and now is. Verse 23, St. John 4, when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Say that with me. In spirit and in truth. In spirit and in truth. In the power of the Holy Spirit. In the power of the truth of God. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh to the Father but by me. You can't get through a place of worship unless through the power of Jesus Christ. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh, my God. Tell your neighbor, he's looking for you. Tell him, he's looking for you. The Father seeketh. He's looking. Who's going to worship me? Who am I going to invest in? Those are going to pay the price. Who's going to deny themselves? Who's going to worship me? Who's going to lay down their life like I laid my? Who's going to worship me? Who's going to get to that place that I can bless them beyond measure? Who's going to get to that place understanding that they are of the inheritance? Understanding that they are at Jacob's well of blessing. We all love the blessing of God. We all love to be blessed by God. We all love the Spirit of God. But as he told the woman at the well, as I give it to you, if you taste and drink of this water, you'll never thirst again. The freshness of that water in this well, the Spirit that's in this well, you'll never thirst again. It's time for the body of Christ to agree. How many know it's power in agreement? If we just agree with the Spirit of God, the worship of God, and humble ourselves for the mighty hand of God and worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Give give me this water that I thirst not. Give me this water that I'll never thirst again. She said, our fathers fought for this well. Give me this water. Perhaps there's someone today, my God, that needs a taste of this water. Perhaps there's someone today that needs to experience this water as the woman at the well. Perhaps there's someone today that needs to get to that place of worship. But you have to go through the process. Will there be one? While we're standing, can we stand? While we're standing, perhaps there's someone that wants to taste of this water that they'll never thirst again and give their heart to the Lord. Perhaps. I want to invite the congregation to enter in place with us through a place of worship. With the Lord, true worshipers, He's looking for you. True worshipers, He's seeking you. True worshipers, He's calling you to a higher place of praise. True worshipers, He wants to connect to you. He wants to take you to a place you haven't been before. Going by the way of the wells, the promise to Abraham. Hallelujah. There's a promise unto you, the promise of inheritance unto Isaac, the wells of blessing unto Jacob. And now as you stand at Jacob's well, as you stand at Jacob's well, I want you to enter into a place with the Lord. Your spirit. Bless God. Bless God. Bless God. Bless God. Bless God. Bless God. Thank you, Lord.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
So much power.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Yes, God.
And there is power in the name of Jesus.
I want you to agree in the spirit.
To break every chain, to break every chain, to break every chain.
Yes, God.
To break every chain. To break every chain, to break every chain. There is power, there is power.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
So much power, so much power.
And there is power in the name of Jesus. Oh, there is power, there is power. In the name of Jesus,
yeah, break.
to break every chain, to break every chain,
break every
to
chain.
Break every
chain,
to break every chain, to break
every chain,
oh, to break every chain, to break,
oh,
to break every chain,
to break every
chain, to break every chain, oh, to break every chain. There's an army rising up. Oh, there's an army.
There's an army.
Oh, rising up. Oh, there's an army.
There's an army.
Oh, rising up. Oh, to break every chain.
To break every chain.
To break every chain, oh, to break every chain, to break every chain, to break every chain, oh, to break every chain,
break every chain,
to break.
Father, in the name of Jesus, as we come right now, oh God, we just thank you, God. We thank you, oh God, for these your people, oh God. We thank you for a mighty move, oh God, the things that have been opened up that destroy the yoke, praise God, of bondage. Praise God, that may hinder the progress of your people enter into a place of worship with you. You alone are worthy, oh God. Truly, you alone are worthy. And Father, as we renounce everything that hinder the progress of the people's praise, of the people's obedience, of the people's worship, our desire is to enter into that throne room, oh God. They that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth, oh God. Right now, oh God, we submit our will to your will, our way to your way. We renounce self. We crucify flesh, that we enter into a place, oh God, with you. We enter into a relationship with you. We enter into your presence. In your presence is the fullness of joy. Now pour out from your throne, oh God, more grace, more mercy. Pour out from your throne more strength, oh God, as we endure, oh God. Pour out from your throne, oh God, the power, oh God, the power that's in the well, the power, the wellspring of living water, oh God. Let the wellspring of living water spring up, oh God. Let it flourish, let it flow, let it flow. We never thirst again. We never thirst again. Our desire is to be more like you, God. Our desire is to hear from you, oh God. Our desire is to be released to you, oh God. Our desire, oh God, is to manifest your glory. Our desire is to be pure, oh God. Our desire is to be righteous, oh God. Our desire is to be holy, oh God. We realize we've taken the path, oh God. Hallelujah. From faith to faith, the glory to glory. We realize, oh God, hallelujah, the promises are amen and amen. The promises to Abraham, oh God, our eyes are the inheritance, oh God. Father, in the name of Jesus, at Jacob well, the water flows freely. The water flows. Let it flow, let it flow, let it flow. Let it flow, let it flow, let it flow. Let the water of your spirit, let it flow. Let it move from breath to breath. I decree it, let it flow. Hallelujah, let it flow, God. Touch, touch, move, touch, flow. In the name of Jesus, as they yield to you, as your people yield to you, oh God, rain down your glory. Hallelujah. Rain down your glory. We'll never thirst again. We'll never thirst again. We'll never thirst again. Allow your spirit move from breast to breast. Let it be fire. A consuming fire. A consuming fire. A consuming fire. Burn up, burn out, burn up, burn out. Everything that is not like you. Burn, burn, burn. Rain down fresh oil, fresh fire. fresh anointing from your throne. Now saturate your people. Let there be an overflow. Overflow. Overflow in them. Let the spirit of worship be upon them. Let the spirit of praise endow them. The spirit of adoration. We give you glory. We give you honor. And you do all the praise. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Let's appreciate the Lord indeed. Father, we thank you for your word. We bless your holy name. Hallelujah. I feel in my spirit there is one or two people here. The enemy has been feeling your well. And you're asking God, give me a fresh well. You are tired. You dig a well. And the enemy has been feeling your well. And you're asking God, I need a fresh well. Enough room for me. I need not struggle anymore. There is a well you've been digging and the enemy has been feeling it. And you're asking, God, as I worship you today, I need that fresh well that I need not struggle anymore. If you're like that, just